All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Malcolm Dorsey, the CEO of Torr Metals. And Malcolm, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Hi, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so company announcing that you've added to your portfolio by staking some new ground in South Central British Columbia. So I'll let you tell me a little bit about this particular area and what attracted you to it.
Yeah, so it's what we're calling the Kolos Copper-Gold Porphyry Project. So with that, we were looking to add some additional strong copper-gold exploration targets within a different world-class mine jurisdiction in British Columbia than where our Latham project is located up in northern BC, which is up in the Golden Triangle. So now we have good diversification of projects within British Columbia. You'll notice a lot of the same positive attributes as what we had at Latham is also on Kolos. So this includes ownership. Kolos is 100% owned by Torr Metals. We did this through the minimal cost of staking claims. This means that there's no underlying NSR. We didn't have to do any dilution to acquire 100% of the project, which will positively impact our future economics and allow us to put more money into the ground for exploration.
So Malcolm, I understand that this project can be worked on all year round, as a matter of fact. Is that something that you really liked about it, the fact that you can get in there pretty well anytime you want?
Definitely. So with that, we saw there's no need for an expensive or remote exploration camp. Operations will be based out of Merritt, BC, allowing for low-cost year-round operation potential. Along with that, we have a district-scale project, so it's 14,000 hectares in size. It's road accessible from Highway 5. There's actually mineralization that occurs on the edges of Highway 5 through the project area. And forestry roads provide access to all six of our copper gold exploration occurrences.
So obviously there's been some work done in the past. Tell me a bit about what has been done in there up to now. Do you have crews on there yet?
Yeah, so geological crews have already arrived. They're on site, so they're conducting some soil and rock geochemical sampling. We'll also be starting up a property-wide Z10 geophysical survey, which will be imminently. With that, there's some very good high-grade grab samples that have been made in the area. With that, some of our occurrences have historical rock grab samples of over 4 grams per ton gold, over 0.5% copper. These are very good grades for a potential copper gold porphyry system within this district. Remarkably, though, it's been largely underexplored. Although there are these high grade rock grab samples, there's kilometer scales, soil anomalies that we see in the historical data. But with that, there's a lot of room for infill and expansion potential of these target areas. So we'll be following up on those. And of course, we're in the shadow of copper porphyry giants, Highland Valley. It's only 30 kilometers to our northwest. We're also in a very prolific copper gold porphyry belt, which extends really from Copper Mountain, 100 kilometers to the south, up to New Afton, which is just to our north. Within that belt, you find us. You find the New Afton, Highland Valley, and Copper Mountain deposits. So it's where we really want to be in terms of geological setting as well.
All right, we'll leave it there. We'll look forward to hearing what the crews report back on when the time is right. Malcolm, thanks very much. Congratulations on this.
For sure. Thanks, Steve.
All right, there's Malcolm Dorsey, the CEO of Torr Metals.